In a recent development in the Rafael deal case, the Supreme Court today asked the central government to disclose the pricing and strategic details in a sealed envelope within 10 days.
All the aspects now relating to price, relating to selection of the offset partner, and relating to procedures are to be submitted. The court has expressed a desire to go into all of them. So they have asked the government, on each of these three matters, you send us detailed information. We have already gone through what you gave us, but we are not expressing an opinion at this time on those what you have given us, but you give us more detailed information. Now covering procedure, which was the first point, second, price, third, selection of offset partner, and give this to the petitioners and to the petitioners in person and to all advocates.
On the 14th of November, when the matter would be heard again, the Supreme Court is going to decide what is it that it can review and what it cannot. It made a very interesting observation today that none of the petitioners had sought any technical details and none of the petitioners had cast any aspersions on the suitability of the aircraft. In a widening rift between the RBI and the central government, the government today initiated consultations under Section 7 of RBI Act. The Section 7 of RBI Act allows the central government to direct the RBI governor on public interest matters. Bloomberg Quint's Ira Dugal explains what this means.
I cannot emphasize the importance of this development enough, but first, the news that has come in, we have confirmed from our sources, and this was reported by the Economic Times earlier, that the government has issued several letters to the Reserve Bank of India under Section 7 of the RBI Act. Just to tell you what this Act says, the Act says that the government can give directions to the RBI in exceptional circumstances in public interest. It's a very broad throwaway line in the RBI Act, which is intended to be used only in exceptional circumstances. But it looks like the government has issued letters, and I'll go back to saying several letters to the RBI, not yet invoking Section 7, but the process that it follows is that they first send a letter saying that we are beginning consultations under Section 7. The RBI governor and the government then have consultations, and then perhaps the government goes in and gives directions.
After a gruesome attack by Naxals in Chhattisgarh yesterday, which killed a DD camera person and two policemen, a new video by another crew member of the Doordarshan channel has surfaced. With gunshots in the background, the crew member of Doordarshan channel recorded this message, assuming that this was his last message to the family.
एक रास्ते से जा रहे थे, आर्मी हमारे साथ थी, अचानक घेर लिया है नक्सलियों ने. मम्मी अगर मैं जीवित बचा, गनीमत है मम्मी, मैं तुझे बहुत प्यार करता हूँ. हो सकता है इस हमले में मैं मारा जाऊं, परिस्थिति सही नहीं है, बचना मुश्किल है. यहाँ पर 6-7 जवान हैं साथ में, चारों तरफ से घेर लिए हैं.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi unveiled the Statue of Unity in honor of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. But that was not all that was happening in Gujarat today. The farmers and tribals were protesting against the inauguration as it was underway.
आज जिस प्रकार स्टेच्यू ऑफ यूनिटी के नाम से डेवलपमेंट के नाम पर आदिवासियों का वहां पर जल जमीन जंगल को लूटा जा रहा है, और जिस प्रकार आदिवासियों को वहां पे लोभ लालच दिए जा रहे हैं कि हम आपको वहां पर नौकरियां देंगे, हम आपको वहां पर रोजगार देंगे, इसके विरोध में आज आदिवासी समुदाय वहां के स्थानीय आदिवासी पंचायतों के पास स्टेच्यू ऑफ यूनिटी के बनाने के लिए परमिशन नहीं ली गई. इसीलिए ये हिटलर शाही शासन जो चल रहा है उसके खिलाफ आज गुजरात का पूरा आदिवासी समुदाय है, और ये आंदोलन आगे भी चलता रहेगा.
Former MEA Minister M.G. Akbar has recorded his statement in Patiala House Court today in the defamation case that he filed against
journalist Priya Ramani. In his statement, Akbar said that Ramani's allegations were baseless and defamatory.
So at MG Akbar's hearing today in Patiala House Court, he recorded his statement for the court to try and convince the judge as to why a case of criminal defamation was made out. At this stage, he did not add to any, did not add any details to what he had already submitted in his written complaint. What will now happen is that on November 12th, he will bring some witnesses to give statements to sort of back up his arguments that this, that these statements have been made which have lowered his reputation. The truth or the falsity of these, of the statements by Priya Ramani are not going to be looked at right now. It's just at this stage, the only question is, were statements made which harmed his reputation? That's what the witnesses will also focus on November 12th. Once that is done, if the judge feels that yes, there is actually a proper criminal case here, in that case, then the actual case will start. Priya Ramani will be summoned as an accused in the case. But for now, we're just going to be hearing more arguments as to why Akbar's reputation has been damaged.
Setting aside a trial court judgment, the Delhi High Court convicted all 16 PSA officials and sentenced them to life imprisonment in the Hashimpura massacre case. All the 16 accused were acquitted by the trial court earlier. Apple has launched three new products yesterday: iPad Pro, MacBook Air, and a Mac Mini. And here are the key takeaways for you.
Now, the new iPad has been given a complete refresh with the Face ID and thinner bezels and the all-powerful A12X Bionic chip. They have completely redone the MacBook Air, the supposedly affordable laptop from Apple, although the affordable has gone above a lakh rupees of price. They also upgraded the Mac Mini CPU unit for the first time since 2014. This one comes in two options, 32GB and up to 64GB of RAM, which is going to be great for the professional video editors and people and graphic professionals who use hardcore softwares like Photoshop and AutoCAD and that kind of stuff.
For latest news and updates, log on to quinn.com. Also, don't forget to like, share and subscribe.